proprietor.
What are you doing here?
And nice to see you too.
I'm sorry, it's just that I didn't expect you, that's all.
I hope you've hidden your secret lover away.
Look, you need first team football. I can't give you that at the moment. QPR can. It'll do you the world of good.
Think about it, you're not playing your best football, are you? Go down there for a month, come back a different player.
I'm going to do the move to QPR. Don't worry, fellas. Italian stallion will return.
William's in the creche, and you and I can have a good gossip. What's been happening while I've been away? Linda's pregnant.
What makes you say that?
I don't know, really. Woman's intuition, her sickness, the way she looks. Have you noticed anything?
Can't say that I have, no.
She's very pale, don't you think?
I hadn't noticed.
Whatever. It's got me thinking. Seeing my father so ill and missing you while I was away just made me realise how short life is. Maybe now is a good time to have another baby. What do you think?
What a beautiful day!
Babes, have you missed me? Have you missed me, eh?
Missed you,
Eddie. Yeah, well, it's good to be home. Hot just to beware the Italian stallion. He's returned.
He's coming.
Hey, Scotty.
How you doing, man? You all right?
Yeah, boy.
Welcome home, sunshine.
Good to see you, bro.
Mate, we missed you so much. We got you a little prezzy.
Oh, yeah, what is it then, eh?
It makes life easier for pile sufferers.
Yeah, you've been on a bench so long, QPR, mate, we thought you might appreciate it.
Come on, come on, be fair, eh? You know, I started twice. I scored once.
Yada, yada.
You know, I've subbed four times. You know, the whole QPR stuff, it weren't me, was it, eh?
Oh, you're back.
What are you doing, man? Look, I'll play football. Come on,
man. This is what?
Boys. Morning.
Morning.
Can I see you later?
Yeah. I need to talk to you about Teddy Mariana.
Gone to my office now.
Yeah. You all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. I need to speak to you there.
Sorry.
Sorry.
Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine, thanks.
No chance, mate.
Come on, son. Said he was a man.
Eddie, you've got to do a lot better than that, son. Come on. Never know. Four and five. Couldn't get
away, couldn't ever get it anyway. What was he doing when he was there?
Son. And five.
Get it, go on, son. Come on, eh?
Drag back. Yo, what's up with you? Too much pasta or something?
Come on.
Listen, I've got to whiz up to see Linda. Take over, I'll see you in a bit.
What's up, mate? Bit of a culture shock roundabout for you, eh? You want to practice sitting on the bench a bit more than you?
Hilarious, bro. Hilarious.
Come on, what's up with you?
Hi.
So, Eddie Mariano?
I want us to finish. Completely.
Yeah. Kitty's got a good idea. You're pregnant.
What? You've not said anything, have you?
No, of course not.
She guessed.
I suppose she's gonna know sooner or later. The whole world's gonna know sooner or later.
So, you haven't changed your mind then?
No, Ray. I'm keeping this baby.
Kitty asked me if I knew who the father was.
Then we've got to stop it. You've got a family. We've got to forget about us altogether.
That'd be the sensible thing to do.
Do you want to?
I don't see any way around it.
No.
Do you?
Like you say, it's probably the most sensible.
Go, Lucas. Nail it.
Nice one, son.
Go, my son.
Fletch. Aye, up, boy.
Cheers, Eddie.
See the shot.
Well, Lucas.
Target.
And he nails it. Mogliano's next. What can he do?
Mate. There you go.
Eddie.
He couldn't even get in the power.
Hey, Lucas.
Come on.
Do you know, he still ain't sorted my contract out, mate, since Bandelli arrived.
Well, I checked my agent. He said just let it be, mate.
Mate, you should be on a parity with the highest owner of the club, mate. Same as me.
Scott.
What?
Lively, come on.
Well done.
Lucas!
Shot, mate.
Fletch, concentrate.
Ooh. See, that's what I'm saying, boys. The whole QPR shot, mate, was all wrong. You know, Francis
Eddie,
pulls...
The gaffer wants to see you in his office.
Well, now?
As soon as. Get the ball, Eddie!
What?
I suppose Sensible's out then.
There's no way Kitty can know I'm the father.
Well, of course she can't. For our sake. The club's sake. God, can you imagine what would happen if the press found out? They'd have a field day. It'd probably make the story of the year.
Think of the baby. Imagine the attention the poor little fellow would get.
Hey, it might be a girl.
There's no way I can stop seeing you.
Oh, sorry.
Right, I'll sort Mogliano out then.
Yeah, 60,000 off the wage bill a month would be a great help. Thanks, Sandra.
What? You were poor this morning. QPR didn't work out.
Who said what?
When I send a player out on loan, I expect one or two things. He either works hard and comes back eager to play for me, or I get an offer from the club. I've had neither, because you didn't do your job.
Yeah, we're set up at QPR, you know, it's all completely...
It's as good as anywhere in the country. I'll be honest with you. I'm disappointed in you. You've got talent.
Yeah, well, I'll be out for this morning, Gaffer, right? You know, I was off the pace. It's just being back, I was nervous. The lads all cheering me up, having a laugh.
I don't see any future for you in the first team.
Oh, come on, Gaff.
I'll give you a month and then I'll put you on the transfer list. And I'm being generous.
Gaff, I'll step up to work, mate, all right? 100%, I'll put it in.
Or you can take the offer we've had for you. A club in Finland are interested, FC Jazz.
Jazz? Oh, what is this, Gaff, Jazz?
They're in the Finnish First Division. They played in the Champions League a few years ago.
Jazz, Gaff, I'm good enough to play for you, honest.
Well, I don't think you are.
Yeah, well, I think I am, all right? I'm sick and tired of being pushed around this place. I've got talent, and I'm staying here. You know that feeling you get. You feel you're older than time. You ain't exactly sure.
Keep the receipt.
Where have you been?
Yeah, Andy went mental when you didn't come back, mate.
Yeah, I went for a drive, didn't I? You've moved everything around. What's going on?
Yeah, we thought it looked better.
No, we can put it back, mate. Look, what is it you're looking for, mate? What is it?
Finland. The Gaff wants to transfer me to Finland.
What?
No, mate, that's Africa. Finland's up there.
Whoa, this Finland place is near the North Pole. It's going to be brass monkeys all year round, isn't it?
Who are you going to be playing for?
Is this where Father Christmas is from?
That's Lapland, you spoon.
There's some interest in me from a club called FC Jez or something.
Who?
They've qualified for the Champions League, all right?
All right.
Jez? As in, nice.
I don't know, all right? Well, I fancy a beer, guys. You fancy a beer, yeah? Yeah?
Later, maybe.
Yeah, we're going to go down for a game of pool, aren't we? Do you want to come?
Oh, well, thanks a lot. Yeah, don't let me hold you up. Well, have a nice time, okay, boys?
I wasn't expecting you.
Yeah, no.
You're right.
Yeah, I'm fine.
Anything on Linda? What's the gossip?
There is no gossip. The baby's mine. Linda's having my baby.
Was that the only time? In Paris?
Yes.
Is it still going on?
No. Look, I have to tell you because I love you. It was stupid. I've never done it before and I'll never do it again. Look, can't we just talk about it?
Yeah, we'll talk. While I was burying my father, while I was looking after your son, you were having an affair.
I'd like another drink, huh? Where did that come from then, huh? Sorry, sis.
Could I have your autograph, please?
You don't want it. You see, I'm going to Lapland. Might as well be a lap dancer. Oh, no, it's Finland, isn't it?
Hi, Eddie.
You don't want my autograph.
You're right.
In fact, could you possibly leave me alone? Because I'm not in the mood.
We've met before, Christmas party, your house. Danny Rawsthorne was taken ill.
Danny Rawsthorne. Now, if he'd really been taken ill, I would have been called back from QPR. Wouldn't I, huh?
But you're back now.
For the time being, yes.
Good. Dragons have missed you. They should never have loaned you to QPR in the first place. You're really down, aren't you?
Really down.
Don't walk out on me.
You are in no position to tell me what to do.
We need to talk. I made a big mistake. I want you. I need you. I love you and Will. Don't go, please.
You should have thought about that before. Come on, sweetheart.
Where are you going?
Mind your own business.
Don't go, please. See, the gaffer's never played me to my full potential, has he? That is the basic problem. I'm a premiership player, ain't I?
Of course you are.
You know, I have vision, ability, pace, vision.
Like when you set up the equaliser for Manchester United.
Man United? Mm. Would you like another drink?
Oh, no, I'm fine, thanks. Do you know what, Eddie? I think you've had enough, too. Look, I'm going to go and get dressed, and then I'll take you home.
Just like all my friends, won't she? Leaving me alone.
Trust me, Eddie Moliano. I'll be back.
A drink, please.
Gaffer, you ready?
Eh?
Aston Villa reserves? The left back you wanted to look at?
Oh, yeah. Can you look at it for me?
Gaffer, you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. I'm just, do you mind looking at him for me?
Fine then, boss, if you're sure.
See you later.
All right.
Linda was wondering if you could spare a minute.
I can't. Tell her I'm too busy.
Letter to Trevor Cutler. I'd like to reassure the bank that all the securities are now in place and the...
Hello?
I can see you. Who are you rushing off to that you're too busy to see?
Yeah, I've got a bit of business on.
Can I see you tonight?
I can't tonight, I'm sorry.
Okay.
See, that beer must have been stronger than usual. Because I can usually drink 10, 15...
I bet you haven't had anything to eat, have you?
You're gorgeous, you know that. I'm not just saying it, but you are.
Thank you.
Do you think one day maybe we could go out for a drink, me and you, yeah?
I'd love to. But for now, I think you better get some rest, eh? Sleep it off.
Funny, I don't feel that tired. I just feel kind of odd, so...
You'll feel better later. $15,000 a week.
Well. Hello.
Oh, I feel grim.
You'll feel better when you've had something to eat.
You reckon, dear? I think it feels a good idea at the moment.
Some soup, bread, and a little salad.
Is this for me? Why did you do this for me?
Because you needed some TLC.
TLC?
I think you'll live.
What are you doing?
Going home.
Yeah, well, don't.
I've got to.
Yeah, but... Look, I'd really appreciate it if you stayed, actually.
Look, I really like you, but... I don't think I should. We've only just met.
Well, yeah, I know, but...
Look, can I borrow your coat? It's turned cold.
Yeah, fine.
Thanks.
Look, I'd really like you to stay, though.
See ya.
Yeah, can you tell me if you got a Kitty Wyatt staying there, please? W-Y-A-T-T. It's urgent. Yeah, I'll hold. You haven't? Okay, thanks anyway.
No, I'm happy to do Socceran, but we're playing away, remember? I'll be travelling. I won't be able to come into the studio, that means we're... Oh, look, just give me a ring when we confirm it, yeah? Oh, hi, I was just on my way out.
Can I come in?
Yeah, of course.
need to know what you want from my husband.
How do you mean exactly?
There's no need to lie. I know about the baby.
Right.
What are your feelings for Ray?
I don't know what to say, Kitty.
The truth is always the best. Let's be honest with each other and make this as easy as possible.
Okay. My feelings for Ray. He told you about Paris.
Do you want to have a baby with him?
He didn't want the baby. I mean, it was an accident. Kitty, I'm going to keep it. We're not going to move in together, if that's what you mean.
So you had a fling. Now it's over.
Yeah. It's finished.
So I see you've had a candlelit supper for one last night, then. Ed?
I met this woman. Most beautiful woman I've ever seen.
And you brought her back here and gave her loads?
No. She brought me back and made me supper.
Right, and?
And she went. With my coat.
With your coat?
She's gorgeous, lads. I have to try and find her.
Eddie, what do you mean, try and find her?
I don't actually know where she lives.
So why don't you phone her?
I don't actually know her number either. In fact, I don't even know her name.
Right. So you don't know her name, and she took your coat?
Yeah.
Eddie, how much did you say that coat cost again?
About 800 or 900.
You can kiss her goodbye, mate. She probably flogged that, gave it to her boyfriend.
Oh, I know what you think.
Right, so where are you going?
Going to the Hell Club, it's where I met her. She's beautiful, lads.
I don't want to destroy your marriage.
Ray pleaded with me to stay, so I don't think he wants to split up. Is that a surprise to you?
No. No.
Why are you keeping the baby?
Kitty. Jerry was against us having kids. And I don't know. I don't think I'll get another opportunity.
I understand.
You're taking this very calmly.
You're saying very clearly you and Ray had a one-night stand. Now it's over.
Yeah.
Thank you for being so honest.
Kitty? Kitty, what's the matter?
Me? I'm fine.
You don't look fine. But why don't you come next door, eh? A cup of tea or something. Come on. Let's go.
Come on, William.
Hi. Look, I'm looking for a woman. I was with her yesterday. Here. Might be in there. Look, she's about this high, brown hair, she's gorgeous. She don't know, do you?
I can't help you, sorry.
I think I found her, thanks. Excuse me. Sorry, wrong person.
You promised me you won't tell anyone. I couldn't bear it if it went round the dressing room.
Ray.
He's been seeing Linda. And she's having his baby.
It was! Yeah!
Wait, have you found her then?
No, bro.
Well, maybe you imagined her.
You know what, mate? I'm beginning to think that myself.
Well, let me get this straight. Mr. The girl arrives. You spend the evening with her. She vanishes.
Yeah, something like that, mate.
No name?
No.
It wasn't on the stroke of midnight, was it? But she didn't leave her glass slipper because she was the girl from the health club. Whoever fits this leotard will be your girl.
Eddie.
hear you've been playing a little bit of jazz.
Oh, do-do-do-do-da-da-do-da-ski-dee-da-da-da. Hey! That's real cool.
We'll be in Finland. It's bloody freezing here.
Listen, brother, have you ever met someone who thought... Have you ever met someone who thought you and me are made for each other?
No, I haven't.
Moliano, you'll find a week's wages for walking out on training yesterday. All right.
Well done, Eddie. Good skill, Eddie.
Well done, Eddie. I need a word with you.
I'm busy.
Now.
Mate, she's an amazing woman.
Bad, ain't you?
No. She's stunning. I think it's amazing what she does.
Okay, the left reset. The ball. Go.
Eddie, concentrate!
Eddie, what are you doing, mate?
She was there, bro. She was there. I swear she was there.
Where you going?
The toilet, Anna. I need the toilet, mate. Sorry, haven't seen a beautiful woman, have you, babe? About this big brown hair? No? Hold the lift!
You told her?
She's my wife.
We agreed not to.
I had to.
So you've decided then that we're finished? She told me you pleaded with her not to go.
Look, I've got a family. You said yourself yesterday we'd finished.
Yeah, and I just had Kitty and William on my front doorstep.
I'm sorry you had to go through that.
Yeah, thanks, Ray.
What have I done? I'm sorry, Linda. Kitty's walked out.
Look. I understand. If you still want to be with her, it might not be what I want, but I understand. I just wish you told me. What did the press find out?
She's my wife. We've always been honest. She keeps me honest.
Listen, I'm going to go back to the health club, all right?
You're pushing your luck, aren't you?
Yeah, well, don't worry about that. I'll be back after lunch, why not?
Eddie?
Yeah?
Someone left this for you.
Oh, my God, she left it. Did she say your name?
No.
Where did she leave it? Where'd she go?
Oh, don't know. She was outside, but that was a while ago.
She's becoming a joke.
I know I've made this mess. When I'm with you, I want to be with you. When I'm at home.
Look, Ray, we've got to sort this out. We're both responsible for running this club. We can't let anything slip. Maybe we were just stupid to start it.
Yeah, I know. You're right. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
You know I said to take it easy.
Sorry?
Well, I know that you've got no one to look after you right now.
Sorry, Fletch, what is it you're trying to say?
I just thought if I took you to dinner, might it help?
Am I glad I found you? I've got my coat back, which is great. I've been looking for you. I don't even know your name, and I was sort of hoping not that you didn't have a boyfriend.
I don't.
You don't? brilliant, because I was wondering hopefully if you'd like to go out for a drink tonight, so I wanted to say thanks for last night and sorry for...
Look, you were having a hard time, it's okay.
Oh, yes. So?
I'd love to go out with you.
You would?
Uh-huh.
Brilliant, so how about tonight then?
I can't, I've got to work.
Well, funny sick.
Look, I've just started this new waitressing job, I really couldn't.
Well, lie, tell him to start tomorrow or something.
I don't think the Grange would buy that somehow. Look, I've really got to go, I've got to get my bus.
Jump in, I'll give you a lift.
Look, I don't want to trouble you.
Your name? I don't even know your name.
Maria.
Maria. Thank you. Eddie's just found a girl called Maria.
Okay, lads, I spent ages trying to find an outfit. Will you give something to choose on, yeah? 2 minutes, all right? What do you think?
No.
What do you mean, no? It's 1,500 quid. The guy that shops at the boy band that was in.
Yeah, well, I like it, actually.
Manly enough, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, next one.
Yeah, Mr. Spock.
Okay. One more. George Russell shirts. No. Blue, yeah?
Blue. Yeah. Now.
That's all right.
Don't show me anything. No.
Would you go? This is it, lads. What do you think? Brothers in arms or what?
Eddie, it's fine. Would you just go?
So what she thinks I'm a prayer?
She won't. Just relax and enjoy yourself.
Okay. She's beautiful, Rose. I'm telling you, beautiful.
You told us already.
You don't think that was super the tiles better, do you?
Go!
Oh, I'm going, all right? See you later.
Sorry, it's a bit stiff.
Do you know, I haven't been here since we had that night out with Mad Craig.
I know, grim, wasn't it?
You've had a bad few weeks, haven't you? I mean, with a stalker and then a prat of a footballer shouting at you.
You weren't that bad, Fletch.
Here he is, the man of the hour.
What do you mean by that?
Well, he saved us from Craig, didn't he?
Sir, can I have you?
Yeah, Mogliano, table for two.
This way, sir.
Cool, thanks. Thank you.
And your guest?
Yeah, she's already here. She started work today.
This is a high-class establishment here, sir.
High-class.
You don't seem to be wearing a tie, sir.
A tie.
Take a seat, sir. Have a nice time. Thank you.
What are you doing?
You said you'd come out of me, so I booked a table for two, didn't I?
I can't, Eddie, I'm working.
Yeah, but if I told you this place didn't mind you starting till tomorrow night, that'd be all right then, eh?
Seat, madam.
Take a seat. Thanks, mate. Cheers, thank you.
That's cool.
Oh, good evening.
Don't look now, but Eddie Morliano's over there having dinner with a waitress.
Whatever makes him happy.
Oh, it's you. I came here to get away from you.
I had to see, make sure you were all right.
We're fine.
I tried every hotel in town. Have you had time to think?
I went to see Linda.
I know, she told me.
She seemed shocked when I told her you pleaded with me to stay, which surprised me because you told me it was a one-night stand.
We saw each other a few times.
It was an affair.
Yeah.
So you lied to me. Did you lie when you said it was over?
Look, I want you to come home. I'll do anything.
Is it over between you and Linda?
It is, yeah.
Just a little. Come.
Did you ever hear from Mr. Block?
No, he disappeared off the face of the earth, thank goodness.
Leaving you his fortunes.
And one or two problems.
Do you know that me and you have been at the club longer than anyone else?
Yeah, you're right.
A toast. To the old-timers.
Watch it.
Listen, I don't think I'm being forward sort of can't you enjoy me like this.
It's the most romantic thing that's ever happened to me.
Good, good.
Look, I'm just worried about my job. I haven't worked for a while and this is my first break.
So what did you do before this then?
I was a secretary at an internet business. It was good. They put me in charge of the whole office, but it went bust. It's been a lonely few months.
That ain't the best news, is it?
Well, my boyfriend left me the same time I lost my job. Hopefully things will pick up soon.
Sorry to hear that. Well, I'm pleased, actually. I don't mean like that. I mean, I'm sorry you lost your job, but I'm pleased you ain't got a boyfriend. Cheers.
Cheers.
Why don't you come home? I'll be more comfortable there. I'll sleep in another room.
Ray, I'm not ready to come home. You only told me this yesterday. It's not just an affair. Linda is having your baby. Have you thought about that?
How do you mean?
I mean, you're the father. What would your relationship be to it?
I'd give Linda money.
You wouldn't want to see it, spend time with it?
No, I don't know.
And there I was, trying to talk you into having another baby.
You must find running the club a huge strain.
It's almost taken over my life. Very exciting, though.
It's very impressive for a bird. No, seriously, though, I admire what you've done. Let alone the financial stuff there's dealing with the press as well. I mean, you can't be seen to put a foot wrong, can you?
Well, that's the game, isn't it? You either sink or swim. What about you? You happy?
I don't know. I suppose I'd like to have got that England call. Ah, but there you go. Ain't gonna happen now, is it?
You're not worried about getting old, are you, Fletch?
Ooh, time's ticking. You can't stay at the top forever, can you? But I would like to find a club where I can play out my final years.
Why not Harchester? You're our local hero.
You and me, we've seen it all, really, haven't we? The FA Cup. Europe.
Crash.
Luis Amor Rodriguez. Are you over him?
As I'll ever be. Fletch, do you mind if we go home?
Are you all right?
I'm not actually feeling too good, a bit tired.
All right. Excuse me. Bill. You're not yourself, are you?
Listen, Maria, there's something I'm meeting in Warski. You ain't got any Italian blood in you, have you?
I have, actually.
I'm from Sicily, by any chance.
Yeah, why?
Because my family's from there, ain't they? You know, it's amazing. My old man's always going about me sort of going out with a nice, beautiful Italian girl. Look at me, eh?
Have you ever been out there?
Yeah, loads of times. We see family all the time.
I've never been. Family came over ages ago.
Maybe one day you'll go, eh?
That would be nice.
How are you feeling now?
Fine, actually. Much better. Listen, do you want to come in for a brandy? Say sorry for spoiling the meal.
You didn't spoil it. You can't help it if you feel off colour.
Come on, then. I'll see you soon. Brandy's over there. Help yourself.
All right.
Message. Message one.
It's me. Take care.
End of messages.
Here you go.
Oh, no, thanks.
What's the matter?
I had a really good time tonight, Fletch.
What's wrong?
I'm in a terrible mess.
What?
Here, sec. Bella. Look, make a seat and get comfy and give us your coat and I'll go and hang it up for you.
Oh, thanks.
Look, do you want a cup of coffee or something a little bit stronger or...?
A coffee would be great.
All right, cool. Make yourself comfy.
You're thinking of travelling?
No. Club in Finland just put an offer in for me. I just wanted to see where it was, that's all.
You're not going to Finland?
No. Although they have been in the Champions League, you know, but, you know, offers, you know, get put in the plans all the time.
Um,
Look, Marie, I'm really sorry I ruined your first day at work, you know.
I can't imagine a better day at work.
All right. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, hello.
Hi.
We used to know each other,
I should say.
Christmas party.
Oh, of course, yeah.
Look, I'm just going to freshen up, okay?
Yes, absolutely.
I do remember it is. So this is it? Your new bird?
Yeah, mate, yeah.
All I can say is I hope you didn't do too much in training today, mate.
Because you're in for a treat tonight, believe me.
What? What are you saying, Campbell?
All I can say is you're a very lucky man.
You telling me you've been there?
And the rest of the Premiership.
I've done something really stupid, Fletch. It doesn't matter.
It's all right. You don't have to tell me if you don't want to.
Don't.
What?
How could you? You know, tonight I really thought there was more to you than meets the eye. But you're still the same old Fletch as you always were.
Well, Linda.
What did you think? You could take me out to supper, then get me into bed? Maybe you were going to brag about it in the changing room tomorrow.
No, well, hang on, all right? I didn't mean to...
I think you should just go, don't you? Look, wait, Fletch, I'm sorry. Listen!
Well, I'll leave you two to it.
I heard what he said.
That doesn't really matter now, does it?
You don't believe him, do you? Got many girlfriends, has he?
Well, come to think of it, no, I don't think he has.
Thought not. Blokes like that get jealous. Make stuff up and spoil it for other people.
Look, Marie, you don't have to go, babe, all right?
I'm sorry, he's ruined it.
Yeah, but he doesn't have to, does he, eh?
But he's your mate. Don't you believe him?
I don't know if you say it's not true. No, I don't.
You mean you don't think I've been with all those footballers?
Of course I don't. You're too lovely for that, ain't you, eh? Maria, I'd really like you to stay this time, all right?
Are you sure?
Yeah.
I'd like you to go now. I don't know when I'll be in touch, but one thing is certain. If we were to stay together, there is no way I would allow you to work for Linda. I couldn't bear the thought of you seeing her every day. So if we were to get back together, you would have to give up your job. Maybe you'd like to go away and think about that.
Going to you?
No one's got their closet to me, mate. But she's taking you along for a right old ride now. She's going to take us away and she's going to skin you alive.
Get out now! Hello. Hi, Sugar.
Cara mia, vorresti sposarmi?
Who's that?
Will you marry me?